Hello, welcome once again to Stuff Things Plays. I'm your good friend Bradley, and today it's a very still night, almost too still. I was actually just jumped by a pack of wolves. I had to slaughter them. I had no choice. It was them or me. And Isabella must protect her. I am here. Very far away from our camp, way over here in Lemoyne, the state of Lemoyne. I was trying once again to get into this area. Since it didn't work to try to go by boat into Blackwater, I thought I'd go over here. I thought I'd be sneaky. I went to Awanjila Dam, but as soon as I crossed over here, just swarmed by Pinkertons. Kind of ridiculous. And then I was trying to go, oh, maybe I can go through here, but no, this is also mountainous. I couldn't really traverse it. So then I was going to head back to Lemoyne and then probably do the Bill Williamson this mission, but then I noticed that there is a little stranger mission that has developed here, and we're gonna go check it out and see what's going on. So let's do it. Yeah. It's another edition of Stuff and Things Plays After Dark, when we let it all hang out. There's lots of talk of genitals. Man, these boars are going crazy here. Hey, babies. Whoa, Isabella. I thought I reined you in before you started climbing that hillock. Let's go up here. Oh, look, look. There is a cabin. Okay. I hear somebody screaming.
Help! 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 You better shut up that pretty mouth. Stay back. This here is a prop.
I don't think so, buddy. Jesus Christ. Oh, she's gonna try to shoot me. Hog time. Got a gun. This is the second woman I've rescued off of the back of a crazy man's horse. All right, here we go. Wait a minute, why do I have Midnight's pistol? Cattleman's revolver? What the hell? This is insane. Why do I have this gun? This is ridiculous. No, put that back. I don't know why I have that gun.
Get me free!
I'm coming. How you doing? This happens with frightening regularity in these parts. All right, let's go, honey. I guess I'll drop you here, cut you loose.
Put me down now!
All right.
Are you really gonna leave me tied up?
No, I'm cutting you free now, woman. God, that's a little bit of gratitude. All right, how you doing? You all right?
Oh, thank the Lord you showed up when you did. Oh, the things he said he'd do to me.
All right, you doing all right now?
It's all right, ma'am. It's over now.
Thank you again.
No problem. All right, let's go see what this dickmonger's up to. The last time this happened to me, I tried to take the man to the cops, and then I got arrested for it. Hello? I'll just leave you right there. Have fun. All right, let's go see what's going on with these strangers. And let me get to my horse and change all my schniz. Why do I have these stupid guns going on here? I want to have my Schofield. Where's my Schofield? There's my Schofield. There's my other Schofield. Thank you. All right, we're still good? Still have the right ones? These are my custom Schofields. Now, Isabella, you stay here. I'm gonna go talk to the person in the cabin. Howdy.
Well, what's eating you, partner?
What? This guy looks a little anachronistic. He looks like some prep school kid from the 30s or something.
Eating me?
Oh, I'm sorry, I'll dry up.
What?
See, I'm, Hey, can I ask you a strange question? I mean, it sounds ridiculous, but I'm on the level.
I don't have a clue what you just said.
Well, I'm sorry, sport. There's these funny rock carvings. They look a bit like this.
Okay.
Okay, yeah, I've seen one of those.
I sort of, like, really badly have to find all of them. Now, it's sort of a puzzle thing of me.
This guy is out of time. He's not from this time period.
Up and up, and it's really important.
Little rock carvings.
Yeah, exactly. Little rock carvings.
What do you want to do with them?
Well, it's sort of very complicated, and you'll think I'm jazzed if I tell you.
You're what?
Drunk?
Are you?
No, huh, I wish. No, I'm, lost. It's a long story. Can you find the carvings?
I have no idea. Oh, Actually,
I did find one.
You mean
or two?
These?
Yes, yes.
Well, I was out looking for treasure.
Where's the rest of them?
What rest of them?
No, I need all of them. Then I'll pay you handsomely. Let me sketch these down.
All right, so this is like the dinosaur bones and everything else.
Here's my card.
What if I can't find the rest of them?
Well, I'm sure you can, sport. I'm sure you can. Francis Sinclair.
Arthur Morgan.
Pleasure.
I don't understand. Why do you need these things?
Well, I told you. If I told you, you'd think I was on the hooch.
What?
I'm gonna have a lie down. I don't feel very well. And neither would you. But, hey.
Look at his...
What harm could it do?
What a lunatic.
You see his belt and his sweater and everything? This is all wrong. Okay, let's look at this card. Mr. Francis Sinclair, collector. Nothing on the back. It was like he was from the future or something. It's very weird. Let me look at my satchel. I got also Mindshare. Wasn't there something else that was updated? Geology for beginners. Francis Sinclair asks you to help find rock carvings hidden throughout the world for reasons he can't explain. One found the kind of blah, 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 blah. Mail back to Francis Finney Post Office. 10 of 10. I've already found some. Huh. Okay, I found one or two when I was out looking for treasure. What is going on? This guy's from the future. Alright, he's not letting me in anymore. Alright, well hopefully that resolves itself at some point, because that was very odd. He's saying sport and hooch and everything. It's like he's from the 20s. Weird. Okay, now where does this go? We're very far afield here. I'm not sure if we want to do too much more exploring around here. I guess this loops back around to Strawberry. But look, we've got... Why do I have a marker here? I must have found something there at some point. I was near here when I was doing some treasure hunting at one point, but I can't remember what I was doing. I have several markers on the map, and I think this is where there are a bunch of deer I saw once. Like, I just have several that are kind of pointless. I don't even know what they're for. But I think we're going to head back to Billy and do his mission. We'll have a very long ride ahead of us, and I will probably cut it short so you guys don't have to experience the entire thing.
You're good.
All right, gang. That was a nice little jaunt, a nice little ride across the country. That was about 6 minutes, 5 or 6 minutes. We're almost there now. We weren't galloping this hard the entire time. I let her lope a little bit. Didn't want to tire her out too much.
Move.
Arthur, it's very rude. All right. We're going to slow it down. Almost to camp. Or no, we're not going to camp. We're going to Rhodes. Bella needs some food, faux show. Let's hold back. Let's hold back here. Bella is a hungry little horse. She needs, that'll give her everything. Fill her up. Man, I'm hungry too. Nope, I'm not whistling. Let's get a nice big hunk of pork. Minty pork. Excellent. It still gives me tooltips about my temporary horse. The Hungarian half-breed is apparently still following me around. Anyway, we're coming into Rhodes. We're going to see what Bill wants. I have a feeling we're at the end of Chapter 3. I don't know faux show. Of course, I thought that a while ago, and then it seemed like more missions just kept appearing. But we should see. Last time, Bill had a robbery. I don't know if that's going to be the same. I think Dutch told me that it had something to do with the Greys. There's some other dialogue that you guys missed. It sucks when I end an episode sometimes and then I'll just kind of walk around camp and then people talk to me. I had a great conversation with Tilly about how she didn't like being in this state because of the attitudes towards black people. And that was interesting. And then I had a conversation with John about Dutch. John seems to be worried about how Dutch has been acting lately. There was a conversation, I think you guys saw, where Dutch was hitting on Mary Beth now, which is irritating. I don't know. There's all sorts of interesting things that go on in the camp.
Like better than usual. Well, I paid just for you.
Let's go talk to these idiots. All right. What do you want?
Been waiting for you, Arthur.
Well, I'm sorry to have kept you.
Come on. Let's get going.
What's the plan?
We're meeting a couple of the Greys over at the saloon. They spoke to Bill about a job needing security.
After the farce of stealing the horses for them, why
do I need a shotgun?
Because we need to stay in with them, and they're paying.
So what kind of security they want?
We're about to find out. Now come on.
Got a bad feeling about this.
Sure. Dutch said we was to keep on dealing with them until we find this gold.
Can we trust them?
Can we trust anyone?
Yeah. Let's just see what they say.
They
said there was some big misunderstanding about them horses.
And what if they were born in their fields?
They don't know we had anything to do with that.
Oh, that's so.
Yeah, they think it was the Braithwaites. Listen, I know these Grey boys a bit now. This is on the level.
I'm just going right through the manure. I can't change.
In the middle of some ancient feud, but instead of playing both sides, Arthur. Being used by both of them.
They were saying the Catherine Braithwaite.
Hey, hold up. This don't feel.
Now it don't feel right. I could have told you.
Holy shit! And yes, I should have my freaking shotgun. Reload, Arthur. Yeah, he's dead. His face is gone.
How could you not think this was a trap?
You sure you want to talk about this?
Okay, I need a freaking shotgun, man.
You see a way out of here?
Not right now.
Shoot the fucker. Sorry, I'm going to be swearing. Reloading too much. Okay, let's get them both, shall we? Watch out, Micah.
They're in the gun store. I'll get the fuck.
Shoot a man in the back of the hand.
Is that Bill? Okay, which way are we trying to go? Enter the back of the gun store. Where's the frickin' gun store? Let's go this way.
Real heavy over here, fellas.
Okay. Let's go. Oh, shit. Going from the daylight into the dark. I couldn't see. Both guns. Okay, there's Micah. Micah's pretty good in a fight, I'll give him that.
Do you see that window and Sean's skull? Don't talk to me about slap.
Better in here, not there.
You sure about that?
Don't be a shallow brain, Tenderfoot.
So yeah, thinking the Greys might be on. After all,
now it's sinking in.
So much for loot. What damn?
I want a rifle.
We ain't getting out of this with nothing. That's assuming we even get out of it.
Of course we're getting out of it.
That's funny. Micah was trying to loot.
We always get the job done.
You call this getting the job done? See Bill anywhere?
No.
Shit.
There's a dude on horseback. Oh. I winged him.
This is some damn posse the Greys rounded up.
We'd have had to deal with these sons of bitches sooner or later. Just turned out to be sooner.
You Greys must be even dumber than I thought.
Oh.
We played you boys like a fiddle. Now you're gonna pay.
We still don't know if Micah betrayed me before. With the O'Driscolls. Okay.
Not all of them.
Now where do we go?
Sheriff Gray. And what about Bill? Where the hell's he?
We'll find him later.
Sheriff Gray!
I'll just do a little looting while you jaw with the old sheriff. You didn't know for a while, buddy.
We put down four worse
Yeah, then why is every single one you put against us dead, my friend? Oh, great.
Guns on the ground, now! Both of you!
Nope.
Don't do it!
You know we can't do that. You put the gun down, Sheriff!
I'll blow his brains out! You want to join your little friend
It's
there?
Time for some Deadeye.
Either way, you're a dead man. Morgan?
Here we go. Oh, shit. I meant to do... Okay, Micah got one of them. That's fine. Okay, we're good. Sean's face was exploded. That was just so out of nowhere.
Well, how the hell was I to know?
Let me see. They set us up once before. They didn't like us. We destroyed their farm. Should I go on?
Go easy on him, Morgan. He was out trying to find a lead. Same as you. Same as Hosea. All you do is complain when things don't work out.
Yeah, things have been a little rough for me lately.
You don't know what you're talking about. You don't give a damn about nobody but yourself.
Oh, you act so high and mighty, but you're no better than the rest of us.
Shut up, Micah.
I've been with you boys close on, what, 6 months now? And all you ever done was complain. You can fight, but you can't think.
Oh, shut up, Micah.
Okay, cowpoke.
Bill, take the boy's body. Bury him proper someplace quiet. Micah? Best you and I don't speak for a moment.
I'm just so frightened by you.
I better get to kill him at some point. Fools. I really don't like him. There's got to come to a head at some point where Micah betrays us, or it's obvious that he's betrayed us, and then Arthur has to deal with him. And I hope I'm there when it happens.
He was like an annoying little brother to me. What fun we had riding together. What a goddamn mess we're making of things.
All right. Roads in the surrounding area are now in lockdown. Remaining lawmen in the area... Remaining lawmen in the area will be looking for you. No kidding. All right. So what do we have available to us now? Arthur, Micah, Bill, and Sean go to meet some of the Greys and Rose. Discuss security job. Kill 3 lawmen and Deadeye while saving Bill. I only did 2. Complete within 4 minutes. Get 20 headshots. All right, whatever. I don't care about that. I would like to look at my map, please. Okay. We've got Dutch. And it looks like that's it. So, Calaga Hall's locked down. Rhodes is locked down. Doesn't look like there's a bounty there. So I guess we're going to go jaw with Dutch a little bit and see what's going on. I have a feeling we're in the end game for this chapter here. Right, Bella? Bella, do you have my hat, Bella? Can I get my hat from you, Bella? Where is my hat, Bella? There it is. Now, wait a minute. Is that my old good hat now? My brown one? No, stop it. I keep pressing the wrong thing. So there's this one. Okay. And this one. I don't know. I don't know what's going on. I think my new one is getting a little browner with use, but now I seem to have 2 stalkers again. One of them had disappeared for a while. Hats are important, people, and there's a train, and it's very loud, and it's annoying me. Ugh. Whoa, Jesus! That thing almost collided with me. You see that, Bella? Whoa, okay. Let's get the hell out of here. Let's get back to camp. Things are getting crazy. I'm pissed off that Sean is dead. I'm pissed off at Micah. I hate him. Hate Micah. Where am I going? Am I even going to camp? I thought I was going to camp. What? I did not put a waypoint at camp. Okay, I just rode right past it. I'm all out of sorts. Yeah. Arthur is not in a good mood right now. Especially after all that bullshit of being captured. I know that was a... Oh, watch it. I know that was a betrayal. And I swear Micah was in on it. The way he was talking. He was just laying it on really thick about, oh, we've got mouths to feed. We have to feed these people in camp. Like, he doesn't care about that at all. So I really feel like he was betraying me. And then the way that everyone, like, Arthur shows back up to camp and people are like, oh my God, are you okay? But it wasn't really that big a deal to anybody, it seemed like. And then later on, Arthur is like, well, you were gonna come for me, weren't you? And Dutch is like, oh, yeah. Like, it didn't seem, I don't know. Everything seemed weird. I didn't like it. It didn't sit well with me.
Calm down. This will all be okay.
Let's see what Dutch has to say.
Everybody, just stay calm. Not time to get hysterical. We're gonna find that boy.
Arthur, have you seen that boy, Jack?
No. Jack?
Where's my goddamn son? Where is he? Where's my son? Well, they took him, didn't they? They took my son.
Who took him?
We think the Braithwaite woman took him.
Jesus.
Kieran saw a couple of fellows sound like Braithwaite boys.
Where's my son? If anything, where is my son, Dutch Vandal?
Because of the glitch in the game that has been known for a while, Jack, Abigail, and Sadie Adler have been missing from the camp, like most of chapter 2 and all of chapter 3. They will show up when there is a mission for them, but it's hilarious that she's asking where's Jack, because I haven't seen him forever, because he hasn't been here.
Lynn.
We will find him. We will bring him
back
to you.
And the Grays, Sean.
Any fool that had the temerity to touch one hair on that boy's head. Abigail, you have my word.
Just get me back, my son.
I will get that boy back, so help me God. Right now!
Dutch! We just heard about Jack. You need some extra guns?
Yeah, why not? Micah, Kieran, anyone strange turns up, you kill them! Rest of you, let's ride!
Alright, it's all going to hell. Burning every bridge.
Okay.
Burning it all down.
Get that boy back.
This is quite the posse here. So, is anyone going to mention the fact that the Grays turned on us?
Yeah. We just got shot to hell by the Grays in town.
I know. I heard about Sean, too. I don't want to even think about that right now. We have to focus on Jack.
I swear, I'll kill everyone there.
Easy, John. Try to stay calm.
That was another conversation I ever heard.
How the hell did they get to him?
I don't know.
Ah, there's too much dialogue. Where John was talking to somebody about, I guess he was talking to Dutch, and John isn't convinced that Jack is his son because Abigail was a whore. Like, she was having sex with other people. Like, that's how she was brought to the camp to begin with, and they fell in love and ended up getting married. But I think he, in some ways, doesn't want to take responsibility for Jack, and so he uses the idea, well, maybe he's not even my son, as sort of a way around that. By Red Dead 1, which takes place after this, he definitely does feel like he wants Jack as his son and wants to be a father to him. In this game, he's a little hesitant.
Well, we are getting him back and they will pay. I promise you that.
What about the gold?
Who gives a damn about the gold? They got Jack.
There ain't no goddamn gold.
But I don't think there is any gold. If there is, it's hidden somewhere no one knows.
What?
I've turned every stone.
Christ's sake, Hosea. After all that, another perfect scam.
We underestimated them.
No, they underestimated us. Enough talk.
Yeah, and
there is no point arguing.
There's another little point where I saw Hosea. Hosea is sick. He's got some sort of terminal illness. I'm not sure what. Maybe tuberculosis or something. But he was coughing up a storm, talking about, he's always making that ginseng compound for himself.
Okay, get your heads right. Nobody make.
It's time for the shotgun, people. Oh, not the double barrel.
I say so.
Oh, now they won't let me change. Okay, here we go. Pump action. The pump action shotgun with slugs. It does the trick. Music is awesome. Atmosphere is awesome.
All right, everyone. come to me.
All right, Bella, you stay out of the crossfire, honey. What else do I need from you? Maybe I'll grab a repeater as well. Got my Lancaster repeater. Got my shotgun. That's good.
First Sean, now Jack. We should have stayed out of all of this.
Bit late for that, ain't it?
Quiet. We're going to fix this right now.
Like they don't know we're coming.
Come on, let's get this done. John, you sure you're okay?
Like I said, I'm fine.
Follow my lead. Both these redneck families think they can ruin us.
This is going to be a slaughter.
I don't think so.
All right, gang. I thought this chapter was going to be ending. Obviously, we're going to have to move on after this.
Who steals?
Look at these trees, dude. Beautiful.
I'm going to let fly at those sons of bitches.
John, I need you to stay calm. Get down here now!
This is awesome.
You inbred trash!
What the hell do you want?
I bet they don't even have Jack.
Easy, John.
We've come for the boy. You must have known we would.
Shouldn't have messed with our business now,
yeah, maybe
should
they
you?
Do.
Whatever complaint you have with us, alleged or otherwise, that is a young boy. That is not the way you do things. Hand him over.
Get the hell off our land.
Oh, Jesus. There are quite a few. All right. Should we be slaughtering these people if they have the boy?
If you ain't gonna be civilized about this.
He is a hostage. Oh, watch it, Dutch. What was that? Did I take one right to the head? Usually I can take quite a bit of punishment. That was odd. And I think I was using my repeater too, by the way. I thought I had the shotgun. They keep loading me up with weapons that I don't intend to be using. There we go. Shotgun, please. Okay, take a little cover. Oh, not there, not there. There. Take cover. Oh, for fuck's sake. That's not where I want you to take cover. You are dead. Nope. You will die. Oh, look at how it destroys the banister. That is so awesome. Okay, yeah, they're behind the pillars. How am I gonna get in there? I can throw some dynamite. No, it won't let me shoot over the cover there. God damn it. Okay, right here. Arthur! Arthur, no, Arthur! Get out of there! Arthur! Arthur! Sometimes the cover mechanic is not amazing. Look at it destroy the stone. That is so cool. Reloading. Okay.
Arthur, John, Hosea with me. The rest of you, watch out here for any other arrivals.
I can't get in there?
Get in there!
I could have done that.
Find Jack and find that Braithwaite woman!
Jack, you in here?
Can I take this hat? Jump on the coffee table. You're raising a barn? I'm gonna look and see if there's anything cool. Inspect this letter. My eyes. Catherine Braithwaite, Scarlet Matter, Lemoyne, dear Signor Brante, thank you for the message of last week. I trust you know that I always appreciate your candor. I would, however, urge you to reconsider. We are too proud, and ancient families have worked together successfully for 5 years now. Letter to Angelo Brante. We have always provided a quality product and paid our debts. You, in turn, have been the most valued of customers. Now, when faced with a small cash flow problem and a minor disruption in supply, you are threatening to derail a successful business relationship. They mentioned Cubans before. Out of respect for you, I will not allow you to do such a thing without a fight. We will not cover the agree that we have grown bigger. but we will pay with the interest within the quarter. My spendthrift middle son has reformed his ways. This will not continue. As for the supply problems that disrupted business, this is a matter we have resolved entirely, as I told you. What is she selling them? Angelo Bronte. Oh, there's a coin purse. Yeah, yeah, I know, Jack, but there's some interesting things in here that we need to look at. Remember that somebody said they hated Cubans? It was the horse traders, right? Break lock.
Jack? Oh shit!
Oh shit! Jesus Christ. Kinda forgot what I was doing in here. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm busy. I'm looking for shit. Alrighty. Arthur keeps jumping onto things.
We should go see what Dutch wants up there.
Just hold on. I am looting.
Arthur, we need you up here now.
Shut up, Dutch. There's something else here. No, no.
Okay. Let's go help Dutch.
Okay, fine. Fine. God's sake. Oh, not the lasso. Not the lasso. Ah! God damn it.
Open the goddamn door! Shit! John! Arthur! We'll hold it down. We got more coming in! Arthur, get out there! We got this door covered!
Ah, shit. Alright, I gotta shoot some people.
Here's a rifle over there if you want it!
Oh god, they've got Molotovs. Better get take him out before they throw him. Oh, that's Bill. I was about to shoot Bill. I probably shouldn't be using this for long range. Alright, let's switch to the repeater. Who else? Dude back there. Music is awesome. All right, gang, we're taking him out here. Oh, I am so good. I'm amazing. Shooting people. Okay. Ow. Come on, get behind cover, Arthur. He will not get okay, there's a problem. There is a problem. I will not target, and I will not get behind cover. What the fuck? Okay. I don't know what was going on there. The controls were wigging out on me. Javier's down there. We are killing everybody in this state. Reload, Arthur. Yeah, he's running away. Alright. That door doesn't open from here. Okay, help John break the door.
Did you find another way in?
Oh shit. What the hell was that? I think John is attacking from over here. Okay, here we go. Watch out. Watch out, John.
One, two, three. Ugh.
Bam! Oof. That'll do it. Alright, where's Jack? Now don't hurt the old woman.
Kill you too, old woman.
You bastards!
Where's the boy?
Well,
We have lived in this house for 120 years. We never had no problems except for
Where
Yankees.
Is the boy? Who took him?
You killed my son!
Oh, and I will surely kill the rest of them unless you start talking.
Oh, I know your type. Common scum.
Where is the boy?
You filth.
You are not in the position to hold that sort of attitude, my friend.
What about down?
Holy shit, Dutch. Just executing people?
Now let's get this hag outside. Any more of her sons to deal with?
No, reckon they're all dead.
Jesus Christ.
That's right. Burn this dump to the ground.
Leave the manor with Dutch. Dutch is losing his frickin' mind. It's not letting me loot. Nope. I wanted gold. I wanted some sort of riches for doing this. Is there anything else in here? Alright, I guess there's nothing. Everything's just going to hell. Let's just get the hell out of here. We're gonna burn it down, I think.
You got that one, Arthur?
I'm not. Jesus Christ. Is he just gonna leave her in there? Okay, maybe they kidnapped the little kid, but Jesus Christ.
Put me down, you dumb Yankee! I never liked you.
Why'd you take the boy, Mrs. Braithwaite?
You stole
my boys are
liquor.
Off limits.
You stole my horses. Ain't no rules in war, Mr.
Matthews.
Yes, yes. That's it.
Where's the boy?
My sons gave him to Angelo Bronte. So my guess is Saint Denis. Either there or on the boat to Italy.
Let's go! Arthur, come on!
What are we doing with her?
Leave her.
I told you she was crazy.
Okay, so that was the letter we read. Angelo Bronte, she owed him money. So she sold Jack as, like, a slave to this person or something? Huh. Things got a little bit escalated there quite quickly. Out of nowhere. At least now...
It's gonna work out, John. Oh. It's gonna work out. Listen to Dutch.
Now, I don't expect you to understand this, but I have never been more proud of you. Than I am right now, brother. You're doing the right thing.
If I don't get that boy back safe, she'll kill us all.
I know, but looking at this logically, well, that boy is fine. They took him to scare us. Nobody takes a boy to harm him.
Oh, yeah?
Right, John.
What do you think, Arthur?
My boy will be fine. But, well, of course, Marston's scared rotten. We killed all those people. We stirred up all that trouble.
Why wouldn't they kill the boy now?
No. No. Not for nothing. For living. Now, we get that boy back, and we go. Trust me.
Hey, Dutch! We got a problem.
Not a problem. Visitors.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
A solution. Good day, fine people. Mr. Vanderlind. Mr. Matthews.
Oh, my God.
And who are you?
Rip Van Winkle.
Huh. Good day, sir. Agent Milton, Pinkerton Detective Agency. Agent Ross. Ah, Mr.
It's freaking Ross. Oh, my God. It's amazing. The visceral response of absolute seething rage and hatred I had when I saw Ross. Ross is from Red Dead 1. which takes place 10, 11 years in the future. And by that point, he is a government agent. And he is responsible for so much horrible bullshit. Responsible for killing John in the future as well. He is filth. Oh my God.
Morgan, nice to see you again.
And to what do we owe the pleasure, Agent Moron?
I don't know if you're aware, but this is a civilized land now. We didn't kill all them savages only to allow the likes of you to act like human Sadie. Dignity and basic decency was outmoded or not yet invented. This thing, it's done.
This place ain't no such thing as civilized. It's man, so in love with greed, he has forgotten himself and found only appetites.
And as a consequence, that lets you take what you please, kill whom you please, and hang the rest of us? Who made you the messiah to these lost souls you've led so horribly astray?
I'm nothing but a seeker, Mr. Milton.
You ain't much of anything more than a killer, Mr. Vanderlind. But I came to make a deal. It's time. You come with me, and I give the rest of you 3 days to run off, disappear, and go and live like human beings someplace else.
You came?
It's not a bad deal.
Risk life and limb in this den of lowlifes and murderers so that they might live and love? Ain't that fine?
I don't want to kill all these folk, Dutch. Just you.
In that case, it'd be my honor to join you. Excuse me, friends. I have an appointment to keep with.
Oh, come on.
I think your new friend should leave now, Dutch.
You're making a big mistake.
He's gonna betray all of you eventually, gang. Yeah, I know you're loyal.
We have got something. Something to live and die for. How awful for us. Mr. Milton, stop following us. We'll be gone soon.
I'm afraid I can't. And when I return, I'll be with 50 men. All of you will die. Run away from this place, you fools! Run!
Come on.
Get your damn hands off of me, boy.
Ooh.
What now? We get out of here. And quick.
Boy.
Any ideas?
I know a big old house. Hidden in the swamps outside Saint Denis. I'm sure they'll find us eventually, but it should buy us a few days.
A few days is all we need.
There's a spot out by Shady Bell. Lenny and I got into that dispute with the previous occupiers. Places we
Oh, right, right.
Hidden. You and Arthur.
Where we got the guns.
Make sure no one else has moved in. Lenny, you go follow those fools out of here. Make sure that they leave. And John, we'll get Jack back. And we'll get going.
Rest of you, get packing!
Come on, John.
Jesus, we're still going.
We'll get packed up, but we need a new spot. All
right. Is this a point where I can stop? I don't think so. I don't think I can save. Let me check. Nope. Okay, we have to keep going. All right, extra long episode, gang.
Yep.
We have to keep going.
Follow me. I know the way.
All right. We're going. Let's go a little faster.
It's gonna be all right, John.
We should be going for Jack.
We will. We have to move everyone first before that bastard Milton comes back with an army. We ain't no use to Jack in jail or at the end of a rope.
I don't even know what to think no more.
Just gotta keep our cool. Be smart about this.
Smart? Are you joking? We made too much noise once again. They drew right to us. I mean, how many people we killed the past few weeks?
Far too many.
It's Dutch playing his games. Hosea, too. Getting involved with those two families. Master con men working their magic.
They thought there was a lot of gold.
Yeah, they thought there was money. Ain't there always?
Look, Marston, I don't know what to tell you. Things don't always work out. That ain't nothing new.
Jack's gone. We lost Sean, Mac, Davy, Jenny? And for what?
We can't change what's done. We can only move on.
But one day, we need to start learning from our mistakes.
Come on, it ain't all bad. We've had a rocky run, but we'll be okay. We'll get through it.
Dutch will fix it. Dutch will come up with a big plan. Right now, every plan gets us into worse trouble. We're getting further from where we're meant to be
going. It's interesting how much Arthur is defending him still.
You're worked up. You're rightly so.
I'm feeling that's not going to last much longer.
Don't get too far in your head with all this.
Especially with what he writes in his journal.
It's a goddamn mess.
He's obviously questioning him just as much as John.
This life. He didn't.
I don't know. I think this life chose us.
But he has to defend him in front of everyone else.
Dutch? Hosea? It's been a long time now.
Sure has. Lots changed.
I sometimes wonder if things was ever the way we remembered them. If we were ever who we thought we was.
Like I told you, don't go down a rabbit hole with this, Marston. That won't help nothing.
I treated Jack bad. Abigail, too. I didn't want to believe he was mine. You know, when I was lost on that mountain after Blackwater, part of me thought I could just leave again and no one would ever know.
But some wolves thought otherwise. Look, you're here now, and this spot we're going to is close to Saint Denis. All right, should be just down this path to the left here.
So, what were you talking about before?
As soon as we get the others safe, we'll find this Bronte and get Jack back.
So what is this place?
Lenny found it. Big old run-down plantation house. Another gang was holed up there for a while, but we sent them on their way. That's it up ahead.
Four walls and a roof. We're moving up in the world.
This should be an interesting location for a camp.
Yet.
Come on.
I wonder if we'll have, like, rooms instead of tents. Why did I stop? Okay, let's take it off cinematic mode.
You sure this place is empty?
I ain't sure on nothing.
Still has, like, the defenses, which is kind of cool.
Let's leave the horses here and take a look.
Stay there, Bella.
Oh, shit! It's them again!
Oh, shit. Alright. Bye. Arthur Morgan coming through.
I can see that. You think there's more of them?
Yep.
I'll check the house. You keep watch out here.
What else? Whoa, getting close to the mic. Search the rooms for the Lemoyne Raiders. I invite you to shut the hell up. You're gonna suck on my shotgun, buddy. Ow. Love the shotgun. Have you ever shot a shotgun with 3-inch slugs in it? My god. It's fun.
Any more of you upstairs? I'm coming for you. You hear me?
Where are you creeps hiding? Come out where I can shoot you.
You're the one hiding, buddy.
I'm gonna be real happy to shut you up.
You think you're tough, Yankee? Come in here and fight.
Oh, his head just disappeared. Oops. I did a little dolphin dive there. Break it. You don't need to look around. It's just, nobody can see you. Kentucky bourbon. Look at. He has no head. It's completely disintegrated. Alright. Nothing too exciting in here. There must be some more raiders left, though. Maybe in here? Nope. Alright, there's some yellow fog over here I'm gonna search. Break lock. All right. shows a body in there, which is weird. On the mini map.
I knew you'd come soon enough. You are some of the coward, like you. The bounty hunters, the freedmen, the carpetbaggers, the army of criminals who stole our land.
All right. The war's been over for 30 years, you dick.
I survived them all.
You're not going to survive this.
Our fight will live on.
Jesus.
Well, save me the slug. That's pretty cool. This whole mission, this whole structure. Ooh, premium cigarettes. Vistas of America card set. Does this guy have anything on him? I'm gonna loot him. Platinum band. Alright. I don't think there's much else going on in this house. I'm gonna go check this one last area. Oh shit! Shoot! Jeez!
How's it looking up there?
Yeah, it's fine.
I think that's a lot. Didn't even have to shoot the last one.
The second to last one.
Come help me with this, will you?
All right.
Everything all right up there?
Yeah. I'm coming. So, are we all living in the house, or are we going to set up tents outside? Where is he? What's he doing? Oh, he's just getting the bodies.
Here. Give me a hand moving these
all
bodies.
Right. I guess that's probably important.
Follow me.
I don't know how much longer this is going to go, gang. Where are we putting them? Is there a well? I probably don't want to dump in the well.
The bodies in the swamp over there.
Alright. Ooh, I bet there's some alligators in there. This should be fun. Gators, supper time! I will drop you right here.
Yeah.
Okay. I can deal with the rest of the
body. Oh, look at them float.
You go meet up with the caravan. Guide them in.
Alright, see you soon.
Oh, I have to pick up all the other bodies. I want to see a gator come eat it. Oh, there's one. Look. All right, see you, John. I'm busy. Is it going to come over and get him? I've never even checked to see if animals will eat people. Like, I wonder what would happen if you hogtied somebody and left them in the forest to see if wolves would eat them. I bet they would. I'm going to have to try that at some point and get some predator bait. Alligator, over here. Alligator. Look, I'm here. Come here, alligator. I don't want to get too close. Oh, for God's sake, there's bodies. Oh, shit. Okay, let me grab one again. Let me pick this one up. It's hissing at me. It won't let me pick it up now that it's floating. Okay, I'm gonna grab another body. Maybe we can throw it right to the alligator. This is important, people. It's for science. Very important. Jesus. Okay, bodies. It's showing me that there's one right here. It must be up above. Oh, yeah. Okay. Nothing there. Okay, so there's this one in here. Oh, there he is. The leader will be thrown to the gators. That'll be fun. Alright. I'm hoping for some gator action here, people. Oh, going the wrong way. This guy's heavier than he looks. All right, Gator, you still out here? Buddy. Where did he go? Oh, for God's sake. If I don't get somebody eaten by a gator, I'm gonna be really disappointed. Hi-ya! Oh, he's kind of half in, half out. I was hoping the gator would just grab him up. All right, let's try that again. Okay, don't fall over yourself, Arthur. There we go. I guess that's all they're gonna make me do. Here comes the caravan.
Welcome home, all of you, to my humble abode. We got fine living. Ignore the corpses and the alligators. It's paradise.
I love it. Miss Grimshaw, Mr. Pearson, would you two kindly work your magic? Arthur, take a ride with me.
Sure.
God, this is just gonna keep going.
Yes.
Could I have a word with you?
Not now. Come on, Arthur.
Molly is becoming dissatisfied with her arrangements, and Dutch seems to have a wandering
eye. Can you
believe
that, girl? All I've got going on, and she wants to talk.
Everything okay with you two?
I got far more important things to worry about right now than Molly O'Shea.
So, where are we going?
To take a look at this eighth wonder of the civilized world, Saint Denis. I can't.
Oh, Jesus, we're going all the way to Saint Denis.
According to the map, the road up this way should lead us right in there.
All right. I guess this day ain't over yet.
Not quite. Good work back there, Arthur. Everything went okay?
Few loose ends, nothing major.
And John?
About what you'd expect. He's taking it hard.
We are going to get that boy back, whatever it takes. I need you to start asking around in the city for Bronte. Subtly, of course. Public places, maybe start with the saloons. Anyone who can put us in contact with him.
Of course. And what about the Pinkertons?
I'm fairly sure nobody followed us. We moved out fast. We should be safe for a few days here.
And then?
I think we need to move a little further. Put some ocean between us and all of this. The mess with those two families.
Ocean?
Losing Sean. I see things differently now. For a long time, I truly believed a paradise lay somewhere in the West for us. But I just don't know anymore.
So we're leaving the country now?
Maybe. I'm still thinking about it. Whatever we do, we'll need more money.
That would be crazy.
In any case, we have more pressing matters to attend to first.
This is a Western, isn't it? We're not very West at the moment, I know. We're in the deep South. Look at all that pollution. That looks nasty. Jesus.
Okay, there she is. A real city. The future.
Yep.
Big cities. They're
always repellent.
Exactly.
I'll find you in there. Go see what you can figure out.
Yes.
All right, gang. I've ridden through Saint Denis a little bit. Haven't really explored much, but it looks like that's where we're going next. And I think that brings us to the end of Chapter 3 and the beginning of Chapter 4, Saint Denis. And hopefully they're going to give me a chance to pause here. Looks like it. Okay. All right, gang, here we are. Saint Denis, the New Orleans of this game, basically. There's going to be a lot to do here, a lot to explore. Let me look at our map and just get a little preview of what we can expect. We have Angelo Bronte. Angelo Bronte. So these are places for me to look for Angelo Bronte, obviously. And that looks like the only mission available to us right now. Where is our actual camp? That would be important for me to figure out. Oh, here it is. Okay. So right there, Shady Bell. An old plantation house on the bank of the Lanahatchie River in the southern bayou. Blah. Previously used as a hideout by the Lemoyne Raiders gang. All right. We're still wanted in Blackwater. Things are progressing. If we pause quickly and save, I want to see what percentage we have done of the story. Hold on. 46.5. So we're still not even halfway done with the actual main narrative, and not to mention all the side stories and little other challenges and things you can do. But man, I'm loving this game. I love it when you can get in this habit of just, well, not even a habit, but you get into the sort of lulled into the sense of like, oh, I'm just playing along, doing these things. There's some missions that don't seem necessarily all that important to the main story. And I was doing a lot of side things, and then suddenly just smacks you in the face with a lot of really good plot, really cool set pieces, and a lot of character development, and just things are happening. Things are progressing in the story, and that's cool. I'm still loving this game a lot. I hope you guys are too, and I hope you will continue journeying along with me as we go through the game. But until next time, until we meet again, I've been a good friend, Bradley. I'll see you later. Bradley. Howdy.
Partner.
Just admiring your horse there. Gracias.